So why are you not resigning? Why are you not going to resign, Mr. Swarbrick?
On Friday morning, Gareth Swarbrick was adamant he'd remain the chief executive of Rochdale Borough-wide housing. Not even 48 hours later, and a board that supported him have now sacked him. In a statement, the Housing Association said the board has taken the decision to remove Gareth Swarbrick from his post as chief executive of RBH with immediate effect. We will now work to appoint an external interim chief executive. Our original instincts were for Gareth to stay on to see the organisation through this difficult period and to make the necessary changes. But we all recognise that this is no longer tenable.
Nothing's going to bring him back.
The news came as hundreds gathered in Rochdale Town Centre to pay tribute to Awaab Ishak, a two-year-old boy who died from the prolonged exposure to mould and damp in his family home. It was the inadequate accommodation and failure of RBH which led to his death.
The family were deeply saddened that following this inquest, RBH did nothing but express their confidence in their chief executive, despite in the courtroom doing everything to indicate that significant changes would be made. The fact that RBH's chief executive had to be sacked as opposed to resign for the family speaks volumes. However, they find it wholly unacceptable that the board expressed confidence in him in the first place. The family still feel that much more needs to be done.
And it was a decision welcomed by Rochdale Council, who are now calling for full ownership of RBH.
I think it's been chaotic from the start, chopping and changing, and first of all, completely stonewalling on the issue, saying, you know, oh, Mr. Swarbrick has to stay. And then suddenly, after all this pressure has been put on them, they do a complete turnaround to sack him as they have done. It's looked chaotic from their point of view.
Getting rid of the man who ultimately holds responsibility for RBH might be welcomed by many, but the death of Awaab Ishak has raised a number of claims of wider failings in an organisation designed to protect and to support people in need.
The culture was horrible. It was bullying, toxic. The amount of people I know who left the organisation were in tears.
For 6 years, Dave, not his real name, worked at RBH before resigning. He asked us to protect his identity as he spoke of his experience at the Housing Association.
The total disregard for the tenants and the cost cutting was completely obvious, and it's really sad, to be honest. I've seen tenants suffering because of this culture.
Awaab's family felt discriminated against because of, they say, what they look like and where they're from.
Rochdale Borough-wide Housing, we have a message for you. Stop discriminating, stop being racist, stop providing unfair treatment to people coming from abroad who are refugees or asylum seekers.
An allegation Dave agrees with.
Is RBH a racist organisation in your view?
In my view, yeah. Yeah, I think it's sad to say, but it is.
RBH accept assumptions were wrongly made in Awaab's case, but said they were not a racist organisation. They told us their culture is one of collaboration and mutuality. Dave also believes there's only one way to avoid another tragedy.
Do you think any more people could die at the hands of RBH's properties?
I definitely think there'll be more deaths due to lack of repairs. The only way that tenants will be safe is if RBH is closed down and the council takes it back over.
We may never know exactly what went on inside RBH in the days and weeks leading up to Awaab's death, but it's clear that for all the unanswered questions, it's more than just the office culture that's in need of repair. Inzamam Rashid, Sky News, Rochdale.